गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर केमल कोचिंग। टुडे वी विल बी सीइंग सॉफ्टवेयर टेस्टिंग यूनिट 1। सो दीज आर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ टुडे लेक्चर। पर्सपेक्टिव ऑन टेस्टिंग, दैट इज बेसिक डेफिनेशन, टेस्ट केसेस, व्हाट टेस्ट केसेस आर, देन इनसाइड फ्रॉम अ वेन डायग्राम वी विल सी हाउ we can categorize different types of testing and in what domain they will be affecting. And later part we will be seeing identifying test cases, functional testing, what is the functional testing and what are structural testing, then errors and faults, what they are called, and different levels of testing. So, what do we test to make a judgment about quality? Why we are actually testing is because we want to make a good quality software. In order to make good quality software, what we can test is the acceptability of that particular software. In construction industry, you can measure it by how many concrete you have added, how many what is the quantity of cement you have used, all those things, steel used, right? But in software, we are generally testing a software on predefined parameters, right? Like whether comment has been made or not, whether documentation has been prepared properly or not, and again whether it is being accepted by the particular user or not. If you are generating a particular, let's say you are developing a software like WhatsApp, if nobody is using that particular software, or if nobody is accepting that software, then it is of no use. So in testing, we want to make a judgment about quality or acceptability of that particular software. Now, some basic definitions are there. Error. What is error? It's a mistake while coding, bug, right? Then fault. Fault is a defect, result of an error. Some fault is of omission. Some fault is of commission. Right? Omission means that you have omitted something, some rules you have not mentioned, or some extra rules you have mentioned. Right? So that becomes a defect. Then a failure occurs when fault executes. Right? When system collapses, we say it is a failure. Incident alerts user occurrence of failure. Right? Incident has some incidents has occurred, means what? Yes. Software has alerted, or we have alerted for a particular type of failure. Test concerned with error, fault, failure, incidents. Then test cases have identity and is associated with program behavior, that is input and output, that what we test. Generally there are test cases. We categorize those test cases because depending upon in what level we are testing. So this is a general life cycle of testing. Somebody says, when do we start a particular testing, or when do we end a particular testing? Testing is a continuous process, right? I cannot say you will start at after this date, right? It depends upon what type of software you are developing, and again it also depends upon how many less errors you want at the later stage. Because if you are testing at the later stage, right, this is a basic like in the diagram, as you can see there are different stages. It's a simple waterfall model it is saying. We have already studied in software engineering, right? So what requirement, specification, design, coding, testing, right? So testing comes at a later stage, but testing will start right from the starting of your or right from the start of your software development, or right from the inception of that particular software. Right? You may say that, okay, sir, requirement specification phase, there will not be an error. Yes, there will be an error. Right? If you have wrongly identified the requirement, then false will be there. Yeah. In design phase also, if you are you have wrongly designed, okay, so if you start early your software testing, then it is likely that you will get less error at the later stage, and the errors which occur at the later stages are more costlier as compared to the errors which occurs at the early stages. Yeah. So this is a basic testing life cycle. So here we start a testing, then fault classification, we classify that particular fault into what category it belongs, whether it is a software fault, functional fault, structural fault, database fault. Like this we classify them, then we isolate the fault. Why we isolate? Because we need not to do changes in every module of that particular software. We need to see where we want to make certain changes so that that fault will be resolved, right? So we need to isolate that fault, and then we need to resolve that fault. And if the fault is resolved, we say it is fixed. Otherwise, we reassign the fault again, right? Now, what is process of testing? Test planning. We first plan the test cases, then test case development. We write the test cases. Generally, test cases are generally written by the developers who are developing that particular software, and then again it can be written by the analyst, which will be analyzing that particular software for the specific requirements. Then running test cases, evaluating test results. Right? It's a simple process. Now you should note down this test cases structure. One or the other point or the structure in the test cases you can omit. Generally, test cases are written in an Excel sheet, where each column represent the particular domain. That is, for example, test case ID. Right? First column will be test case ID. Then you may or may not have purpose of that particular test case. Then precondition, what need to be present before doing the test case, right? So that should be there. Precondition, then what will be the input, what will be the expected outputs, right? So generally, whenever you are writing the test cases in your examination, you need to consider this point, that is test case ID and purpose, means what the test case is meant for. Then precondition, you may include, may not. Then inputs, then expected output, and then the result, right? So here more things are there, that is post condition, what will be the state of that particular software after testing it. So that is what post condition. Then execution history will be there, what is the date, what was the result, what is the version, which version you are using, and who has run that particular test. So all those information will be there in the test. It is very important. You need to note these things. Oh, now it is showing some Venn diagram. Venn diagram, all of you know. It suggests in what domain a particular thing is working. Right? So this is a program behavior environment wherein we are having specification. And another circle P represent program, right? So specification, we have already discussed SRS, software requirement specification, which specify what software need to do or what is the requirement of that particular software is specified in specification. Generally, we consider that whenever a software specification is there, as we are computer engineer, we try to develop it in a different fashion, right? So another domain is program, where you have developed a particular software, right? And there is a little interaction between this specification and program, and this represent what is the difference between the expectation and what you have observed in the program, right? So this difference is there, that's why we require a software test, right? In order to match specification with the program on observation, right? Now this represent what is expected, that is specification, what you are observing in the program, and a certain test cases what we are verifying, right? This diagram represents the perspective of whoever is working in that particular. So expectation is user domain. User is expecting this circle. Right? Programmer is developing this circle because according to his observation or according to his vision, he need to develop a software like this. Right? And test cases which is developed by the tester. Right? That he is having his own perspective. Right? So this area represents how the difference is there, right? So program environment is like this, right? This eight number will represent this one represents the interaction between expectation, observation and testing. Yes, whatever it falls in a proper manner or whatever you can say is verified by the tester that it's okay, right? Then two part, this two represent that a particular interaction between expectation and observation which are not tested, right? And three represent the programmer test cases, the programmer perspective which has been tested. Then this four represent the expected whichever is there that has been tested. Then five represent the expected or the expectation in SRS which has not been tested. Then in six represents the programmer perspective which has not been tested. And lastly, this seven represent the test cases which are not in the specification as well as programmer's domain. Then there are types of testing which we can see. So first one is functional testing. It is also called as black box testing. Why it is called as black box testing? Because we are simply seeing what is the input and what is the expected output that we need to test. So it's like a black box. We did not know what the programmer has written in the code, right? What logic he has used to implement a particular code. So in functional testing or black box testing, we are just testing the functionality of that particular software. So you should do certain functionality. In this type of testing, implementation is not known. We don't know how he had implemented. Function of black box is to understand input and output. So he is having certain inputs and he need to match it with the expected output. So there are advantages. Of course it is simple, okay? Independent of how the software is implemented, you may use any technology. We need to see what is the input and what is the output. If implementation change, test cases are still useful. If you have implemented it using another programming language, then also your test cases can still be used. Test case development can occur in parallel with the implementation. Disadvantages, what are disadvantages? Redundancy may exist among test cases. Redundancy may be there. Redundancy means what? Some test cases may get repeated more than once. Possibility of gaps of untested software. There may be gaps of untested there, because we don't know the entire functionality of that particular software, and so we don't know the technical aspect of that particular software. So we are just testing using input and output. So there will be certain gap, right? That's what different companies you may see. Google is giving a bounty for identifying bugs in his software. Means he is also not 100% sure that his software is without bugs. Right? So bugs are there. Even you can see Microsoft software Windows we have seen, right, from one decade. Right? There also we can see number of bugs are there. There will be gaps between what we taste. Right? So this is the comparison of functional test cases identify method. Okay. So two methods are given. Method A is there and another is method B. Right. As you can see, this Venn diagram suggests that we are having specification, we are having programs, right? Some test cases are more oriented towards specification, some are less oriented toward the specification, that is SRS, right? Then there is structural testing, also called as white box testing. White box testing is everything, whatever functionality or whatever implementation details are there, the tester will be able to know the details and he will testing the details. Even clear box testing, it is also called as clear box testing. This is more oriented toward programmer, so you can see it is more or less oriented toward programmer. The functional way, structural goal of both approaches to identify test cases. Functional testing uses only the specification to identify the test cases, and black box testing can use with us if it uses the specification to identify test cases. Structural testing uses the program source code as the basis of test cases identification. When functional test cases are executed in combination with structural test coverage matrix, twins problem, redundancy and gap faced by the functional testing can be recognized and resolved. Yeah, so if both methods are used simultaneously, you will be able to resolve more number of problems. Right. When we know that what kind of error we are prone to, we can be easily able to identify that particular error. If we know what kind of fault are likely to reside in the software to be tested, we will be able to identify it easily. We can use this employee more appropriate test case identification method. At this point, testing really becomes a craft, right? So, certain testers which are working on that particular software and they know what type of errors may usually occur, right? So they are able to identify those errors easily.